everyone. Welcome back to One and All Kids.
We are in week 3 learning about changing the world in our Make Wave series.
We get to see how growing in the fruits of the Spirit can change the world one step at a time.
Our memory verse this month is Philippians 1:6. It says, "Be confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus."
That verse can help you remember that Jesus is always doing a good work in you. So memorize it as best as you can.
Last week, we learned about how we can show God's goodness to the world by not hiding his light. This week, we can learn about being faithful. Let's look at some faithful friends and see if we can follow their example. Hey, what's up, guys? We're ready for another... What do we call these?
Game?
Games, yes,
ah,
yes,
it's
another
that's
game.
What we're doing right now.
I'm just messing with you, I know what games are. All right.
We play them every week. What are we playing right now?
We got two games up here. We are playing a game called Make Tyler and Josh Sound Like Fools.
Ooh, so this is taboo.
Speak out, yeah. Speak so out. We're gonna be like, ah, la, 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 la. And Yesenia has to try to guess the word we say.
Okay.
Or the word we're describing.
How this works? Okay.
Yeah, so like this word right here is carpenter. So, but we can't say any of these words.
Okay.
And if I do say any of these words, you go.
Oh, that sounds like a dog toy.
Yeah.
That's kind of fun.
And then I have to move on. So,
Yesenia, how much time do we have for this?
The timer is. The little hourglass in front of you.
Oh, that thing.
Yep.
We should use the big one.
No, that's like half an hour. Ooh,
okay. So,
I don't know what that is.
You go first because, you know. I don't know. You have a cool hat. They can pick a side who they think is going to win. So if you think Tyler's going to win, run over there. If you think I'm going to win, run over there. And you guys can compete too. Shout it out. See if you can beat us.
If you think you know the word, try to beat Yesenia at guessing
the
word.
Try and beat
That's
me.
A good one.
Yeah.
That's
see if you're better than Yesenia or not. You know, we're going to find out right now.
I mean, a lot of people.
And then if you see Yesenia and you beat her, make sure you tell her.
Yeah. Make sure you tell her. Also, make sure you tell her that she has to eat something gross too.
Ooh.
No.
Bring something gross for her to eat.
So. Yeah. Like one of those worms from Outreach Weekend. All right.
That's
awesome. Okay, you ready?
All right. You look great. I don't know why my voice got that. That should be that should be your profile picture. All right, here we go.
Go.
3, 2.
This is something you do at the very beginning of the year. It's the first thing you do at the beginning of the year. You celebrate.
Ooh, New Year's resolution.
You celebrate.
Happy New Year.
It's the day of her.
New Year's Eve.
Yeah. All right, this is the biggest mountain in the world.
Oh my gosh, Mount Everest.
Yeah.
Wow, great job. Wow.
There's, if you were to rub your hand on something.
Lotion?
No. You're rubbing your hand on something, like a lull.
Like a lull?
Like a lull. A lull. It's not flat. It's got ridges on it. What do you call that?
What?
Sorry.
Something to rub on a wall.
No. Take your hand.
Okay.
And you are touching a wall, and it has blank.
Die!
Texture.
That was a hard one.
Texture.
I hate the...
That was a hard one. So that one you didn't
I was also
get.
Drooling everywhere.
This one was our
I feel like if you would have gone with sushi, I would have been like texture.
That was really...
What?
If you would have said like...
Oh,
I
food.
Hate,
I should have gone food. I couldn't say...
That was really good though.
I couldn't
that
say...
Was
yeah.
Super impressive.
I couldn't say feel, smooth, substance, shape, or fabric. I was gonna say popcorn ceilings.
Mad props. That was a lot of
risk. That was good.
All right.
I got two. Oh, I felt like you got more. That was impressive.
I feel like I did too, but it was fine.
All right. Okay.
All right. I'm gonna move this and flip this.
It's not comfortable. I'll tell you that.
It's not.
Okay.
All right. I'll start. Try to say the word wall.
Oh.
Yeah. All right. Just to feel some sense of.
Yeah.
Sense.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. You ready?
Like
three.
I'm ready. Sorry.
Two. Okay. One. Go.
Okay. So not chicken pox, but
measles.
Keep going.
Smallpox.
It sounds like. Can I say it sounds like?
No, I don't think so.
So it's like what adults get.
What?
Okay, it's also something else on the top of your... Okay. So if you're outside at the beach, and your
swimsuit, towel,
your arm gets
sunscreen,
hot,
burn.
Okay.
Burn. Sun. Burn.
Yes. Okay.
Nice.
Okay.
Nice.
Okay. When you get celebrated, somebody do this. When you get celebrated. And you get celebrated, and you didn't
surprise!
Know. Yes!
Wow!
Okay. So, you get a mint chip.
Ice cream?
And it's on a...
Cone.
Oh, she's a cone! At the same time.
At the end?
Then it counts!
All right, this is our tiebreaker round. If you get buzzed, you're out.
Out.
You're done.
Yeah.
That's it. You lose. So, we are going into sudden death. Whoever can get Yesenia to guess the most in 1 minute, we're going to go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Whoever gets her to guess the most wins, and if you get buzzed, you're out. Sound good?
Sounds good.
Ready?
Yep. Here we go.
Okay.
This is so gross. I'm drooling everywhere.
Out.
Okay. All right, ready?
I'm nervous.
You could. You could. Okay. Ready? 1, 2, 3, go.
The handle.
Yes.
Three, ready?
2, 1.
Okay, this is, you use this to rest on at night.
Pillow, bed.
The whole thing.
Mattress.
Yes, okay.
It is a
creature that eats really small bugs.
What?
Really
a lizard?
Really small, a big creature that eats really small bugs with its nose.
Is that the Lion King animal?
No, with its nose.
With its oh, elephant.
No. Smaller than that.
What?
Smaller. It's got really... This is so difficult. What it eats is in his name.
It's in its name?
Yeah. It's a really small bug. The bugs are... They're black or red. They make hills.
Oh, anteater.
Yes, thank you.
Nice.
Okay,
work.
When you're resting, it's Netflix and
time chill.
Time's out. Wow, that was good. I was gonna just go.
I don't think I got this one.
Blank, go marching.
No,
I don't think I got that one. So, all right. I'll put that one away.
I just have to beat two.
You have to
and
beat
not
two.
Mess up.
And go.
Okay. So when you get a mosquito bite, it like
swell.
You wanna like
scratch.
Yeah, what is
itch?
Another? Yes, okay. All right, so in order for your shorts to stay up, you need to wear if you want your shorts to stay up.
Oh, suspenders.
You need to wear.
Suspenders?
Around your.
Wait, belt.
Yes, okay. So,
oh my gosh, here we go.
A gorilla likes to eat this.
Banana.
Yeah!
That's it. You
keep going.
You
okay.
Win.
No. If it's gross,
that's a hard one.
If it's gross outside,
you failed.
You automatically lose. Just kidding, everybody. Josh wins. That was a high octane game.
Wow!
Stretching out my cheeks. All right. If you chose the side of Josh, you win. Or if you chose yourself and you guessed all of these faster than Yesenia, I'm proud of you. Make sure you bring some gross food for her to eat. She has to eat it. That's the rule. We love you guys. Go to worship. Have some fun.
Hey, friends. Worship time is here. We get to sing about how great our God is. So get up on your feet and sing and dance with us as we praise Jesus with our two first songs, Rooftops and Chain Reaction.
There is a fire in my heart, to tell the world just who you are. In everything I do, in everything I say, I will never be ashamed, 'cause I just wanna let go. Jesus, you have saved me so, I will never be ashamed. I will sing from the rooftops with all that I have. I'm gonna. this fire in my heart, in my heart. I'll tell the world just who you are, and everything I do, and everything I say. I will never be afraid, be afraid. From the rooftops, with all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands, I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout. From the rooftop, oh, you are my God, oh, you are my God, oh. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. From the rooftops, with all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands, I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout. From the rooftops, oh, you are my God, you are my God.
To the past, and oh, let the young see visions of the future, and I sing, oh, let the old dream dreams again in my world. God, do a new thing, I know you're moving in my world, a chain reaction of holy passion. Stride with you, oh, bursting like heaven in motion. And Jesus, you make me new. I'm pressing on with my back to the past. And oh, let the young see visions of the future. And I sing, oh, let the old dream dream.
Worship time is such a great time to focus on who God is and all he does for us. We get to have one more song at the end of service, but now it's time for our message. So grab your Bibles and grab a seat and get ready to learn with us.
Hey everyone, I'm Pastor Josh, and we are making waves this summer as we continue to learn about the fruits of the Spirit. And this week is all about faithfulness. The best way that we can learn about faithfulness is by looking at people in the Bible who were faithful to others throughout their whole lives. Our bottom line this week is be faithful so others can count on you. Let's say that one more time. Be faithful so others can count on you. Do you want others to count on you? I know that I do. Being faithful is more than just keeping promises. Being faithful means keeping your promises and doing the very best you can to make sure that those around you are cared for. We can see this in the lives of David and Jonathan. When David was growing up, his best friend was King Saul's son, Jonathan. But after a while, Jonathan's dad stopped liking David because David was going to be the next king of Israel. He even tried to kill David. Can you imagine if your BFF's dad tried to kill you? Yeah, probably wouldn't stay friends with them. Because of Saul, David had to leave town. And even though he left, he still wanted to be friends with Jonathan. The whole story happens in 1 Samuel 18 through 20 and in 2 Samuel 9. But let's look at 1 Samuel 20, 42. These are the last words that Jonathan said to David before he left Israel. It says this. Jonathan said to David, "Go in peace, for we have sworn friendship with each other in the name of the Lord, saying, 'The Lord is witness between you and me and between your descendants and my descendants forever.'" Then David left and Jonathan went back to the town. David made Jonathan a promise that he would always take care of Jonathan and his family. This was David's chance to be a faithful friend. Now, many, many, many years later, Saul and Jonathan had been killed in battle. But Jonathan, he had a son named Mephibosheth. Mephibosheth had gone into hiding because he didn't want the new king, David, to hurt him. Mephibosheth was also injured in his legs and couldn't walk very well or even walk at all. But David, he was a faithful friend and welcomed Mephibosheth with open arms and gave him a seat, a literal seat at the king's table. That is a pretty big deal. David not only honored his promise to Jonathan, but he made sure that Jonathan's son got the very best. This is how David shows faithfulness. I have a friend who wants to share a story about this. So let's check in on them.
Hey everyone, my name is Matt Chavez and I'm one of the pastors here. I love going to parties. I don't know about you, but birthday parties, so exciting, so exciting. And one of the big things at birthday parties is the music. For me, I gotta have some great tunes, make you wanna dance and groove, but there's always some good songs that I love that really remind me of friends. And you might remember some of these songs like "You Got a Friend in Me," right? From Toy Story, probably seen that on the movie. Or even "You Can Count on Me," like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. These are great songs about friends. And so when I go to birthday parties, I usually go because of friends, right? We're going with our friends or family. And one of my friends, I can remember way back as a kid because I've had a friend that long. I'm already gonna be getting close to 50. I won't tell you how old I am. But one of my friends I've had since a kid, just as a kid. But this friend, he was amazing. His name was Hector. And Hector was always there for me. He was always there when I was getting in trouble, when I was getting picked on, when I was getting bullied. He somehow showed up. And this guy is not just a big guy. He's actually a very small guy, much shorter than me. I was always taller, a little bit bigger. But he had the fire in him that he would always show up and he would be there to make sure I was always taken care of. In fact, he did that for all of our friends. He was always there for us. And we had lots of fun as kids. He would show up there if we were getting in trouble. He would show up actually sometimes when we were getting into trouble. He kept me always taken care of though. He was with me. He was a couple years older than me. But now let me tell you about this friend. He was with there all through those times in school. He showed up to every graduation, high school, college he showed up to. He was there for me. He came out just to celebrate me, to make me feel like I mattered, like I was $1 million. And guess what? When I got married, he was there too. In fact, he was even in my wedding. I made sure of that because he was such a great friend. When I started having kids, my first one, my second son, my third son, he was there as well. He always showed up and he was always there. And even through many life trials that I had even later on after that, he always showed up. And that encouraged me. That inspired me because I wanted to be a good friend like that. I wanted to be someone that others could count on, just like him. He always showed up. He always cared about others more than himself. And he wanted to make sure he was going to do whatever he said he was going to do. He was going to do it. So he made sure. Those are three things that I always knew I can count on him. So I wanted to be that because I failed sometimes. I let him down and other people, other friends. I wasn't always there. I didn't show up when I say I was going to be. I was going to be late. I wasn't on time. I missed some big performances or the big baseball game sometimes for my sons. But I wanted to be there. So I got to make sure. How do I do that? I got to make that choice and do it. And so I did that. And I got the opportunity to redeem myself. My friend, he was a couple years older than me. His birthday party now, he was having the big one, turning 50 years old. Can you imagine? That's half a century old, right? And we had a great time at his birthday party. But I surprised him. He now lives across the country. I live here in California. He lives all the way on the other side of the country in North Carolina. So I had to figure out, how do I get there? I had to fly. I had to figure out how much time is it going to take. It's going to take at least 5 hours to get there, probably more like 8 because I have to connect through Texas and get to over there to North Carolina. I did that, paid all the money to get there just for a birthday party. Why? Because he was important to me and I wanted to show up. I wanted to be there and I wanted to do something for him because this was important to him just to be there. I wanted to show up just for him. I wanted to care about him more than myself because it was only one day. I had to leave the very next day because I had another wedding that I promised I was going to be at. I had to be there. So I had to do that. But I was able to be there and enjoy so much great time with my friend. And that's what I got to do. But I had to do that. But how can he count on me? Just like he always counted on him. I had to show up. I had to show up. I had to care about others more than myself. That can be hard sometimes, I know. But I cared about him more than myself. And I did what I was going to say, what I was going to do. That's how you be someone that you can be counted on.
Be faithful so others can count on you. Don't just keep your promises, but make sure that you are faithful to what Jesus would do and give them the very best. That is how you become a faithful friend like David. That is how you can change the world. This week, work on giving others the very best and be faithful to your promises. Let's pray. Jesus, thank you so much for giving us the example of David and Jonathan's friendship. I pray, God, that today we can continue to look at your Bible and remember that we can be faithful to the promises that we make and help others see Jesus in our lives. We love you so much, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen.
David and Jonathan were the most faithful friends.
David kept his promise to Jonathan to look after his family, and David's actions changed Mephibosheth's life.
Mephibosheth,
what did I say?
Mephibosheth. It's okay.
It's okay.
We all mispronounce it at one point in our lives, but that's okay.
I am so grateful that there are people in my life who are faithful friends, but I am even more thankful that Jesus is faithful to be with me all the time.
Me too, Tyler. One way I can show Jesus just how grateful I am is by giving my offering.
When we give our offering money, we are telling God that we understand that He is the one who gives us all things in our lives. By giving back our first and our very best, we are telling God that He is the number one thing in our lives, even if it costs us some of our money.
You can talk to your parents and your leaders about giving your offering today.
Worshiping God is another way that we can show God how thankful we are for Him being in our lives. Join us as we sing our last song for the day.
There is no shadow that has ever overcome your light, and there is no rival that could ever stand against your might. You've always been with us. Every battle you've already won. No, we've already won. There is no weapon that has ever left a mark on you, and there is no army with the power.
Some friends as we learn about more Fruits of the Spirit next week. Until then, we want to send you out into the week with one hope,
one life
in Christ.
See you later.
Bye.